like we haven't spoken in quite a while. But it is pretty late. Are you here to kill me? I'm sorry. Just kill me. I know I'm disgusting anyway. You're not here to kill me? Thank you for sparing my life. Makes me feel a bit better. So, why are you here? Are you not feeling well? You can't sleep. Well, I think I know a natural remedy for that. Right here. I have some stories I can read you to help you sleep. Here, you can just lay down. If you're comfortable with that, I don't want to force you into this situation. You're okay? Okay, well, if you'd like, you can lay down on the bed and I'll sit beside you and read you some bedtime stories. This first one is called Big Dog and Little Dog Wearing Sweaters. Little dog has a sweater. Big dog does not have a sweater. Big dog is sad. Big dog wants a sweater too. Big dog is looking for a sweater. Little dog is helping. Big dog has found a sweater. Hooray for big dog. Big dog is putting the sweater on. Little dog is helping some more. Now little dog has a sweater, and big dog has a sweater. Big dog and little dog are warm and happy. Good night. That one was quite a short story, but it's very cute. On to the next one, though. I hope you enjoyed it, by the way. You did? That makes me feel a lot better. This one is called The Golden Girls. Goodnight, girls. This is Blanche, Rose, and Dorothy. They are going to have a sleepover. And this is Ma. It's getting late, girls. Finish up your cheesecake, Ma says. It's time for bed. But the girls do not want to go to bed. They're having too much fun. Dorothy, Blanche, and Rose want to play dress-up. Stop fooling around, Ma says. It's time for bed. But Dorothy doesn't listen. She takes out a game. And the girls start singing. All right, all right. Save the song for tomorrow, Ma says. It's time for bed. But Blanche wants to make something with clay first. And the girls can't go to bed before dancing. Knock it off, girls, Ma says. It's time for bed. But the girls need to say goodnight to Miles and Stan first. Enough already. Everyone into the bathroom to wash up, Ma says. It's time for bed. The girls love their bath. Okay. Get ready for your story, girls, Ma says. It's time for bed. Rose starts reading a story about a cow, a chicken, and a one-eyed pig. Everyone groans. Let me do the storytelling, Ma says. It's time for bed. Picture it, Sicily, 1909, she begins. The end. Now close your eyes, Ma says. It's time for bed. Good night, girls. Finally, it's time for more cheesecake, Ma says. Then, back to bed. And that's the end of that story. Did you like it? I'm glad. It was really cute. The next one we're gonna read is Hurry Up and Slow Down. Hare is nearly always in a hurry. Tortoise, however, is not. Tortoise likes to sleep late in the mornings. Hurry up and wake up. And do some stretches before he leaves bed. Hurry up and get up! Tortoise is cautious when crossing the stream. Hurry up and keep up! He likes to take his time over lunch. Hurry up and eat up! And chew each leaf at least 11 times. Is it time for dessert? When Tortoise plays a game, he plays slowly and thoughtfully. He doesn't make a mess and is always careful to put things away just so. Hurry up and clean up! Tortoise doesn't like having to clean up all over again. Oops. But when it is time for Hare to bounce into bed, what Tortoise likes most of all is to sip a cup of chamomile tea in peace. Hare, however, has other ideas. Can we have a story? Just one. Oh, please, please, please. You're so good at reading, Tortoise. So Tortoise opens their favorite picture book and begins to read the words out loud. In no time at all, he reads all the words on the first page. The second page. And the third are over in a flash. The fourth flies by in a wink of an eye, and Tortoise goes on to the fifth. He is just about to turn the page again, when Hare cries, "Hurry up and slow down! We need to take our time, Tortoise! We need to look at the pictures!" Tortoise looks longingly at his cup of chamomile tea, which is getting cold. Then he looks at Hare and smiles and says, "Let's read the whole book over again." And that is the end of that story. Isn't it so cute seeing the hare and the tortoise interact? So precious. I have one more story for you, and hopefully this makes you sleepy. This one is called Cowboy An Octopus. Cowboy meets Octopus. Cowboy's confused. This dang thing is always broke. "Hello," says Octopus. "I think I can help you get on that side. I'll get on this side." "Yeehaw," says Cowboy. "You fixed it." Octopus says, "Some things work better with a friend." "You want to be friends?" says Cowboy. "Certainly," says Octopus. So Cowboy and Octopus shake hands, and 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 shake hands. Help. Octopus needs help, so he calls his friend Cowboy. "I have to hold all of this together, then hammer this in," says Octopus. "When I nod my head, you hit it, okay?" "Sounds loco to me," says Cowboy, "but okay." Octopus holds everything together. Octopus nods his head. Bam! Cowboy hits it. "Need any more help?" says Cowboy. "No," says Octopus. "Sometimes help from a friend isn't the best help." Chow time. Cowboy decides to surprise Octopus and make him dinner. Octopus is definitely surprised. "Heavens," says Octopus, "what is this?" "I cooked all my favorites just for you," says Cowboy. "Beans and bacon, bacon and beans, and just plain beans, with a little bit of bacon." "Oh my," says Octopus. "Octopus doesn't like beans. He doesn't like bacon." But he does like it that Cowboy has worked so hard just for him. Octopus licks one bean. "Mmm," says Octopus. "I am so full." Cowboy smiles. He's glad his friend likes a surprise. "Wait till you'll see what's for dessert," says Cowboy. Octopus says, "I'll bet I can guess." very scary. Do you like my Halloween costume? Says Octopus.
What are you? Says Cowboy.
Octopus says, I am a shark. Oh yeah, says Cowboy. Now I see your little shark thing. I'm not very scary. It's not very scary, is it? Says Octopus. Cowboy says, nope. I'm going back to my first idea, says Octopus.
Whoa, what the heck are you? Says Cowboy.
Octopus says, I am the Tooth Fairy. Now that's scary, says Cowboy. Very scary. Isn't it a beautiful day? Says Octopus. Cowboy says, no, it ain't. Who's there?
Knock, knock, says Octopus.
Cowboy opens the door.
Nobody there.
No, no, says Octopus. You say, who's there?
Ain't nobody there, says Cowboy.
I know, says Octopus. It's a joke. Cowboy thinks for a second.
Well, dang, it's not a very funny joke.
Octopus laughs. No, Cowboy, the joke comes after you say, who's there?
Okay, says Cowboy, who's there?
Octopus says, lettuce.
Lettuce? Say Cowboy.
Lettuce? Says Cowboy. That's crazy talk. Lettuce can't knock on a door.
Cowboy laughs. This is a great joke, Octopus.
Octopus laughs too. Telling Cowboy a knock-knock joke didn't work out so well, but a lettuce knocking on a door is pretty dang funny. That's the truth.
Do you like my new hat? Says Cowboy.
Wow, says Octopus. That is really, different.
Do you like my new hat?
Cowboy says, nope.
Hey, says Octopus, I said something nice to you. Why don't you say something nice to me? I thought we were friends.
We are friends, says Cowboy, and that's why I'm telling you. Your new hat looks like something my horse dropped behind him. 'Cause that's the truth. Adios, amigos.
And that's the end of Cowboy and Octopus. I hope that you enjoyed it. I might not be the best reader, but I hope it was able to make you sleepy. Oh, I should have been quieter. I hadn't realized they had fallen asleep. So adorable. Well, I guess it's time for some shut-eye. Good night, and sleep well, okay?